Chip, who you
Hi,
I'm Larry Willis.
Hey, you talking to Brian Reese.
Hi, Brian. How are you?
Dan Brown.
Hi, Dan.
My partner.
Eric Shoemaker.
Hi, Eric.
How are you?
Good. Good to meet you. Did you meet Theresa?
I'm sorry, I haven't.
Okay, Bill Rolfe, this is Theresa Brennan.
Good morning, nice to meet you.
And you know those people, I think.
Nice.
She is planning to be with family in Washington, D.C. over Christmas. You don't have a problem with that, do you? I'm going to ask the judge to say it's okay. Okay, I'll give you the calendar and where she's going to be and when and everything else.
Excuse me, Your Honor. I'm a journalist with the USA Today Network, and I just wanted to place on the record that we respectfully object to your ban on live tweeting and live video. you.
Good morning, Your Honor. Good morning, Judge. Bill Walsh on behalf of people. I just wanted to know we filed an amended complaint in charging affidavit yesterday. There was a couple of typos that I want to correct it. I sent those over to the staff here in Livingston. As I understand it, they've been delivered up to you also.
That's correct. I did receive the amended complaint. Defense counsel, did you receive the amended complaint as well?
We have, Your Honor. Can you see me or should I go to the lectern?
I can see you fine with your objection to the amended complaint.
No, Your Honor.
Theresa Marie Brennan, case number 18315
F1. State your appearance for the record. Good morning again, Judge Bill Olson on behalf of people.
Oh, I'm sorry, Your Honor, I'm having trouble following. Larry Willing on behalf of Theresa Brennan, who's standing next to me, Your Honor.
And what's your name, ma'am?
Theresa Brennan.
Today is scheduled for your arraignment. Since you're charged with at least one felony, you have the following rights. You have the right to remain alive. You understand that, ma'am?
Yes, I do, sir.
Anything you say orally or in writing can be used against you. You understand that, ma'am?
Yes, Your Honor.
You also have the right to represent yourself, or if you choose, you can have a lawyer to represent you. You understand that, ma'am?
Yes, Your Honor.
I understand that you retained or hired counsel, is that correct?
Yes.
You also have a right to a trial in this case, and that trial needs to be by jury or non-jury. Do you understand that better?
Yes, Your Honor.
If you want a non-jury or a bench trial yourself, your attorney, the prosecutor, and the court all have to agree. Do you understand that better?
Yes.
You also have the right to be presumed innocent. You understand that, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
You also have the right to have your guilt proven beyond the reasonable doubt. You understand that, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Because you're charged with at least one felony, you have the right to have a preliminary examination within 21 days of today's date. You understand that, ma'am?
Yes.
Counsel, you want me to read the formal language from the amended complaint form?
No, Your Honor, we will waive the reading.
And I've been provided with some proposed probable cause conference dates. However, the dates proposed are beyond the 21 days. The dates proposed to me were Tuesday, January 15th at 8 a.m. or Wednesday, January 16th at 1:30 p.m. Defense counsel, you can choose either one of those days if you wish to wait your client's 21 days. If not, the next day will be January 3rd, 2019 at 10 a.m.
Your Honor, we will waive the 21 days and either the 15th or the 16th will work, and whatever's convenient between those 2 days with the prosecutor is fine with us.
I'm looking at Wednesday, January 16th at 1:30 p.m. Is that good for the people?
Yes, thank you very much, Judge.
Have a 21-day waiver there. You can sign that. It will be dispatched or email a copy of it here. Just to count, like you are counting bonds on behalf of the people.
The defendant's already surrendered her passport. That's in the custody of the Michigan State Police now. We'll put that into evidence. Beyond that, Judge, we leave bond in the discretion of the court.
Just briefly, Your Honor, Ms. Brennan has been a resident here in Livingston County pretty much her entire life. She has no criminal record. Some of the topics of these cases have been the subject of a
Judicial Tenure Commission hearing. She's appeared regularly on time, and we would ask that a PR bond be given. I spoke with the Assistant Attorney General. I don't think they oppose that. We have surrendered the passport at their request to them.
What's that fine? $30,000 personal cognizance. You see her right back on Wednesday, January 16th at 1:30 p.m. for PCC. If there's any outstanding discovery, they should have provided on before January 16th. Questions, counsel?
Only to add to the discovery, Judge, we have sent Mr. Willie a proposed protective order. He is reviewing that. Once we have that together, we'll forward that to Your Honor for a signature, and then we'll tender discovery. We're ready to do that today, Judge.
Brought up by
No, Your Honor, I received that proposal. I'm sure the lawyers can work it out, and I understand until the stipulation is signed, I will receive no discovery, and I'm confident we can work this out between the lawyers.
All right. Well, so the gentleman's here right back on Wednesday, January 16th at 1:30 p.m. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Willie, you got anything to say? Nothing at all?
You don't want to say it's a victory, but you think it's a victory for justice. This judge has wreaked havoc on our community. For the last decade and a half, her entire tenure in office has been nothing but ruining people's lives. So today is the first step in having justice prevail for our citizens. And she needs to resign. I mean, every day that goes by, the citizens are paying over $600 per day for her to stay in office and not do anything and have felony charges against her. This is obscene. She needs to resign, and ultimately, justice will prevail.
And so you felt that this has been, it's been a long time in coming, right?
Oh, absolutely. And we finally stepped up a while back because, frankly, it was interesting that we received complaint after complaint, and frankly, there's not much the legislature can do with a bad judge. We have a judicial tenure commission set up by our Constitution that ultimately does an investigation on a judge's antics in office. And that Constitution literally does an investigation, and that is ongoing. Their recommendation to the Supreme Court should be coming soon. But then we also have a citizen's grand jury that's been requested by a former judge in our Livingston County court system. And then we have these felony charges that are all piling up against this judge. Number one, resign and let the justice system prevail. And in the meantime, we've had Mr. Kowalski, who obviously never had a fair trial. He's been in prison for about 11 years. And if you look at any of the documents from the Judicial Tenure Commission, you can see that Judge Brennan declared his guilt well before the trial even began, because she had an illicit relationship with the lead detective in the case. This is just terrible. You can't even come up with something like this. I mean, this is unbelievable. It's beyond a soap opera. It's beyond a Tom Clancy novel. This is a travesty for our courts and our citizens in Livingston County.
Thank you for making my day.
What's your name, sir?
And benefits of the city of our county and our state.
Yeah, of course. Hang in there, bud. Love you.
Hang in there.
Merry Christmas.
You too.
Of course. We're not done.
Well, I appreciate that.
Appreciate it. Thank you. Take care, gang. Thank you.
How do you think today went, Jared?
I think it went pretty good. You know, it's a good first step. I'm happy that the Attorney General, Bill Schuette, was able to, you know, charge her. And we'll see where the this leads, of course. And she's affected a lot of people's lives, and obviously my father's life, and how she's conducted herself. So a lot of people have been talking about how this does not directly affect my father, but indirectly, it you know, the charges, but indirectly it sure does. And
will you be reaching out to the prosecutor now?
I'd like to. I think it's time for him to, you know, step up, and he's, you know, kept delaying ever since the news came out. He's, you know, let's face it, in 2013, right before my father's trial, he received two letters from Mr. Tom Kaiser regarding the improper relationships to, you know, with the judge Brennan and Detective Furlong. And his office basically had, you know, put their heads down and ignored it and wanted to get the trial rolling. And that was their words that they used, Pamela Moss. So basically, it's time for him. And then ever since this came out in 2017, regarding that it is true that they had, you know, an improper relationship, he still continues to delay and not want to come forward and grant my father a new trial. He prides himself on, you know, upholding the law of our land, the Constitution, and it's clear as day as my dad was denied his constitutional right of a fair trial. So if he wants to do that, it's time for him to grant my father a new trial. He knows my, you know, he also said, you know, if anybody had new evidence to bring it forward, that was in July, and I believe he received some new evidence in the state police, and we haven't heard anything what's done with that. So again, it's time for him to come forward about the new evidence and granting my father a new trial and do what's right.